Good afternoon and welcome. It is great to have you here this afternoon for the whatever number it is, AGO Christmas Carol Concert. It's been a number of them, and we are delighted to be able to host here at First United Methodist Church. This afternoon's concert, if you have not been to one before, you will be able to sing a carol, and then you'll hear each of our organists, they'll play a prelude or an offertory or a some kind of individual piece written on that carol, and it's always delightful. Unfortunately, you'll have to hear me multiple times because I'll introduce each of these, and it's my pleasure for that. I'm going to stand up here. I usually like to stand out there closer to you, but we are videotaping this afternoon. We are not live streaming, but we are videotaping, and they will post it on the AGO YouTube page and Facebook page, so that you can see it later. And hopefully what they'll do is just cut off all of me and just leave the music and just go one, 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 one. The first song that we're going to sing, and I forgot to bring my, what number is it? 211, if you want to turn in your hymnbook to 211, or if you just do words, the lyrics will be up on the screen for you. The hymn, Veni, Veni, Emmanuel. Emmanuel means God with us, quoted in Matthew 1:23. Israel in this song is used in conventional sense of Christians. Could you turn this down a little bit, Kelsey? I'm feeling pretty hot up here. Thank you. Is used in the conventional sense of Christians, and Babylonian exile is a metaphor for the fallen man from paradise. It was first written in a plain chant fashion. And what I carry, I love this concert because I carry my Oxford Book of Carols, which has all kinds of stuff. And it has a transcription of the original plain chant version of this. It was just circles on lines. There were no measures, there were no meter, it was just openly done. And we're getting to sing it right now, just kind of like that, but it's not measures.
Thank you.
it's okay to clap. Yeah, definitely. Hey, while you're turning your hymnal to 224, that's our next one, did you note the name of the composer of that piece, Lester Groom? Well, if you note the name of the organist, Rebecca Groom, Tevelda, that's her dad that wrote that piece, so most dear to her heart. Now, did you ever notice, organists, that dear and dread are spelled with the same letters? Because, and Bach, J.S. Bach, he's either dear to you or you dread him. One of the two. And, you know, I let you choose. If I look at the page, it's dread. But when I listen to it, it's dear. So this next song, In Dulce Jubilo, the good Christian friends rejoice, got one really cool little historic thing. And that is, it's usually said to have been taught to the mystic Heinrich Suso by angels. Suso was a German Dominican monk who at the age of 18 assumed the role of maybe the coolest job title in church history, servant of the eternal wisdom. So, you know, I wasn't doing anything like that at 18, but he was. Let's see.
Thank you.
All right. Now, Brad, you're coming on up. Our next organist is Brad Newcomb. He's the director of music at St. Mary's Catholic Church in Ponca City and is an OSU grad. Yay for you, Brad. if you would turn in your hymnals to 219, we're going to sing stanzas 1 and 2, What Child Is This? And there's a cool thing, there's just so many cool little things about these Christmas tunes. And here's one. William Chatterton Dix led a busy professional life as a general manager of a marine insurance company in Bristol, his hometown, but found time to write many original hymns and to versify existing prose translations of hymns from Greek and Ethiopian churches. Now, I encourage you, go to your insurance agent and see if they'll translate Greek and North African languages for you in hymns, because I know mine won't, and I know I can't either, but it's really pretty cool. This guy did a lot. Are you ready, Brad? Let's sing.
Thank you.
If you want to turn in your hymnal to number 230, O Little Town of Bethlehem, we are bringing up Sam, and Sam is an OSU student. He is also a choral scholar at First Presbyterian Church, and he is going to be doing O Little Town of Bethlehem. And there is something that I learned reading this last night. A lot of us know the story of Silent Night being written on Christmas Eve for service right away. Well, this one has a similar story, not quite as immediate, but similar. But back in 1865, Philip Brooks took a trip to the Holy Land. And on Christmas Eve, having ridden on horseback from Jerusalem, he stood in the field outside Bethlehem in which the Annunciation to the shepherds is said to have occurred, and was later moved by the singing at the service of the church in the Nativity. In 1868, he finally wrote down the hymn which had been slowly growing from that experience. So it was that experience in the Holy Land on Christmas Eve that generated this tune that we will now sing. And what are we going to sing? Verses 1 and 2. 1 and 2.
Thank you.
Thank you, Sam. Now, if you want to get your hymnals ready early, you could turn to 234, but you're not going to sing a hymn before this next song. Bell Choir, are you all on the way up there? Let's go. The Jubilee Ringers from here at First Methodist Church are going to offer a couple of songs this afternoon. This first one is On This Day Earth Shall Ring, or Personant Hodie. And I just lost my place. Oh, it's the one that this is blocking. Wow, it's a good day. Let's see. In this one, it's Personant Hodie is a parody. It's an imitation with a new text of a medieval song to Saint Nicholas. So appropriate that it comes in at church. But no version of the model is known with exactly this melody. But the one in the Mooseburg Gradual, completed in 1360, is close. So the next time you're at home and the coffee table Mooseburg Gradual is just calling to you, you could go look this up. Just kidding, you'd have to see if any of these guys have one, or some music historian at OSU would be the only place you might ever find one. But it has been around for a long time, and then set to a setting by Holst is what's most popular in Europe, and ours comes kind of close to that, but it's very colorfully derived with the bells. Sorry, we have a ringer sick today. So instead of directing, I'm a dingle. Thank you. Ah, that was fun. Ah, they're telling me I'm too fast. Okay. But, hey, it was a good time. Next, we have Michael coming up. And, oh, Brad, the dedicated page turner. Is that what we've got? If we would turn to 234 in your hymnals, get ready for that. And if I can get ready for where I'm at. What are we doing here? Where are you? This is a cool thing. We got to do this. Because I don't have much here. This is Michael Crockett. And the only notes in this, in fact, well, there's two pages of small print notes in here. And I'm going to give you about a line and a half. The genesis of this piece is generally obscured. We're not going to solve it today. Don't care. Michael, we're going to talk about Michael for a second because Michael is the one who coordinated this whole event for us this afternoon, got all the organists organized and all, and I think we should give Michael a thank you for that. And Michael is organist at First Christian Church in Stillwater and a student at OU Medical School in, oh my, in Tulsa. So, you go, Doc. Let's do it.
Thank you.
The next piece is another one from the Jubilee Ringers on In the Bleak Midwinter. In the Bleak Midwinter was a poem written by Christina Rossetti, and she did not intend the poem as a hymn or to be set to music at all, as it was not composed to be set strophically like most hymn texts are. But of course, AGO people, leave it to the organist Harold Dark in England to solve it with a brilliant melody, wonderful tune that we get to hear now.
Thank you. Thank you.
All right, we're going to get Jerry up here. Oh, let's dance. Jerry, come on. Oh, we will dance. There we are. If you want to turn in your hymnal to 247, I believe it is. Don't have it on in front of me, but I think that's what it is. For O Morning Star. And I just have to say, here's what we need to do for this. Oh, tonight we're gonna party like it's 1599. Sorry, wrong Prince, huh? Yeah, Prince of Peace, that's what we're supposed to be doing. But this song was written in 1599 by the author Philip Nicolai. And I had some notes on my phone and I forgot to bring my phone up here with me. So there's some really cool notes on this and I don't remember them, so I'm not gonna say them out loud and bother you with that. But Jerry Frank is going to be our organist for this. And are you ready, Jerry? Almost. Almost. The one time I don't ramble enough. Yeah. Jerry continues to teach organ at OSU, and he's ready to go. Are we doing all the verses on this?
I didn't.
One and three. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jerry. And he's got one more. If you want to turn in your hymnals to 246, just one page before where we just were. This piece has, this setting of Joy to the World has become a requirement of Jerry every time this concert is done. They've all, the other organists and any of us that know have told him, yeah, you got to play the Martin Satchel, and it must be done. And you'll know why if you haven't been to this, you'll know why as soon as it's over. And then you can come back next year and hear it again. Right, Jerry? There we go. Okay. Now, I told Jerry I had my multimedia portion ready for his. And typically with this song, what I like to talk about is the fact that it's a Christmas song that's not really a Christmas song. It's really a resurrection song, more than it's a Christmas song. It doesn't ever talk about the nativity. But it's our beloved Christmas song. But there was something cool in the history of it. And that is that Isaac Watts wrote the text, right? And Watts wrote a piece of Psalms of David imitated in the language of the New Testament. And I went, okay, yawn, that's not what I'm here for. But then I read on a little bit and I found this little gem. They're not conventional translations. And some psalms are admitted, blah, 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 blah. But it says, the well-known hymn, Jesus Shall Reign Wherever the Sun, for example, is from Psalm 72. In some cases, Watts even substitutes Britain for Israel. Right? Rather like a medieval illustrator would set a biblical scene in their own country. And I've always looked at these paintings in art galleries and thought, who was smoking what to decide that people around Jesus were dressed like this? Right? Well, it was just a medieval kind of thing that artists liked to draw, and they placed Jesus 1,300 years after he was gone into their own people. And from what Jerry said, yeah, they used to like it, and they would draw, the painters would paint court members into these paintings. So enjoy that. That's fun and that's funny. There's one other thing I got to do today, and that is, or two other things, is thank you for being here. For number one, or three things. Thanks for being here is number one. Number two, we typically take an offering at this, but I forgot to put out plates, and so I decided, no, I had a thing, but we're not going to do that. What I'm going to do is say the offering has been given to you. It has been given to us by the AGO. When you're passing something, a bell ringer outside of a store with a bucket, or someplace, one of those Christmas trees with the people you can take, think about this and think, you got this gift. You can give it to someone else, pay it forward there. And we'll do it that way this year and say that's good. Number three, if you enjoyed this, just sit tight for about an hour and a half. And there's another concert right here at 5:00 by the Stillwater Chamber Singers, and a Christmas concert, and it'll be dandy as well. So, and you're welcome to that, and that's free of charge and all. So go out, get a coffee, come back, then you'll be caffeinated and ready to go for it. Or if you're like my daughter, you'll be caffeinated that late and never go to sleep that night. I don't, you know, whatever that might be. But I want to thank the organists, and let's enjoy Joy to the World.
Thank you.
Thank you. One more puzzle and the Christmas picture is complete. Can we thank all of our organists once again? Thank you very much. Have a merry and blessed Christmas.